Gun speed and visual lead. It is known that in order to kill the target, a shooter has to send the shot not directly at it, but at some point ahead of the target where the shot is the target will meet. The distance as the target passes after the shot has left the barrel till the target is hit is called ballistic lead. It depends on the distance to the target, its speed and the speed of the shot. However, the amount of ballistic lead does not depend on actions of the shooter. The part of ballistic lead visible to the shooter is called perceived or visual lead. Visual lead depends on the angle the target travels by the shooter and normally not equal to ballistic lead. In the case of an outgoing target, for example, visual lead may be non-existent, though ballistic lead may still be a considerable one. Over the years, visual lead has become a favorite subject of discussions and arguments for shooters. The most frequently debated questions here are the following. Why do different shooters, while shooting at the same target with the same shooting method, often see different amount of lead? Or why does a shooter, while shooting at the one and the same target with different shooting methods, see different leads? And why does he perceive they are different not only at the moment the decision to pull the trigger is taken, but also at the moment gun goes off? And how does visual lead depend, if depends at all, on the speed the barrel pulls ahead of the target? All these questions can be answered if one takes a bird's eye view at the phenomenon of a shot. Let's, for example, take apart pull-away method shot. Here, a shotter mounts onto the target, matches its speed, then accelerating the gun pulls away of the target. The moment the shooter sees the proper picture, he pulls the trigger. Having mounted the gun, the shooter keeps track in mutual position of the barrels and the target. Reflected light permanently entering the shooter's eye hits the retina. Here special cells photoreceptors turn the light into electric signals. These signals travel through the optic nerve to the brain where the images that the shooter sees appear. That is how the shooter sees. When the image appears, which is perceived as the right one, the brain gives the command to shoot. The shooter pulls the trigger. Shotgun mechanics and interior ballistics also take certain time. The shot goes off. So the shot is not an instant act. It is a process. It starts at the moment the right picture reflects in the shooter's eye and ends the moment the pellets go off the barrel. This process takes about 250 milliseconds, which includes up to 50 milliseconds needed for visual image to appear. In our example, the gun all the time had been moving faster than the target. That is why visual lead at the moment the shooter, so to say, started pulling the trigger was smaller than the moment the shot went off. In 250 milliseconds, the barrels had advanced in moving ahead of the target. On the other hand, visual lead at the moment the gun goes off, as the shooter perceives it, will be a bit smaller than the real lead. The reason is already known to us, the 50 milliseconds effect. At the moment the shot goes off, the brain is still occupied by previous, outdated image. Everything we have described above takes place when the gun moves quicker than the clay. In case the gun and the target move at the same speed, visual and real lead will be the same. Let's illustrate what we have been talking about. Here we have three clips of shooting a left-to-right 30-yard crosser made by ShotKam. The shooter used the three basic shooting techniques: maintain lead, pull away and swing through. For each shot, we will use frame-by-frame backward analysis to stop the leads at the crucial moments. 250, 50 and 0 milliseconds before the gun went off. Then we will compare the leads. Maintained lead method. Here, for some period of time before the shot, the gun had been moving at the same speed with the target. Pull away method. The gun accelerates and moves ahead of the target to mount the acquired lead. Swing through method. The gun overtakes the clay from behind and gets ahead of it. Here the speed of the gun was the highest one. First of all, let's make sure that real leads at the shots were the same in all three cases. That is how visual lead looked like at the moment the shooter started pulling the trigger. As we can see, the quicker was the gun, the less was the visual lead. At last, that is the lead the shooter perceived at the moment the shot was going off. Again, the trend is the same. The bigger the speed of the barrels, the less is visual lead.